888.
So I have a question. I just came from your panel that you just did, and I know you guys mentioned about like being your true self, like on social media and things like that. So how do you think you can balance being your true self and promoting yourself without seeming like you're being ungenuine or desperate.
Desperate. Like if you're doing, if you're promoting like a show you're in or something you're doing.
Yeah.
It's more. It's like a. I say like, because even when I'm doing something, it's sort of like I try to like filter it in with just my general content. So it isn't like unless that's a book launch day, and it's like book all day long.
Yeah.
Like it'd be like you try to find a fun way to spin it. Like,
no.
In your voice, like a casual way. Like,
okay.
And like just not over.
Yeah.
Check the board right behind you.
BroadwayCon day 3. I feel like I should update you guys on what I've done so far. I haven't been vlogging, I've just been really enjoying the day. But so first thing that I did was go to the cosplay fashion show because I'm still in my Dorothy outfit. So I did the cosplay fashion show this morning and I went to a panel, and then I don't know what's happening now, but people are like running to get to wherever they're going. Then I did a book signing with actor friends on Twitter. I just found out about him, so I need to follow him. But I bought his book, and I got a clip with him, so I'll be posting the clip. I just came back from the marketplace, buying a few things. Like I said, I'll be doing a haul from that. So now I'm not really sure where I'm going. But when I figure this out, I will talk to you guys.
Found out about Music Video Factory from the Playbill listing. It was when they were building the space, and after the black box was more or less constructed, I came across a listing for performers, writers, actors saying, come in and sing your backing face off. It was the first one in the series, and I knew that I had to go because as a kid in Baltimore, dreaming of like being a part of original musicals, I was missing a link as a New York actor about how I get in the room with a composer. How do I you hear these great stories about performer-composer relationships, and directors loving actors and championing those actors, but I didn't know how to, in a non-Facebook, stalker sense, to get FaceTime with composers and directors, and I really found that home at Musical Theater Factory when I came in and was heartily embraced by Shakina and all of her brilliance and warmth.
And Dan, you want to talk a little bit about now you had this idea, you started these programs, but we'll talk a little bit about kind of what those programs are. But kind of wrangling all of that into a system to keep track of it all. Because one of the things is you start a theater company and you think about starting the theater part, but you don't necessarily think about starting the company part. And kind of
I'm in an empty panel. So watch, as soon as I start vlogging, someone's gonna come in and then it's gonna be awkward. But anyway, I'm just sitting here relaxing for a little bit because I didn't really want to go to any panels right now. It's like around 2:00 and I just didn't want to go to anything. I wasn't interested in anything that's happening right now. But at 3:30, that's when the fun starts because they're going to have a sing-along. I'm pretty much just going to know Wicked songs, I'm sure. But that's what I'm gonna go for, the Wicked songs and anything else that I might know. So it's gonna be a sing-along with different Broadway shows and the songs from Broadway shows. So I'm just sitting here relaxing for right now until the sing-along starts. So I'll be recording some of the sing-along, and yeah, so I'll talk to you guys later.
And then I meet the wizard.
And expectations, and I'm sorry that I can't be there at the very end of it with you, but what I did do was I sent the band some music for a final sing-along, so you have to make sure that everybody in that room joins in. Can you do that for me?
Yeah!
Great. Thanks, guys, so much. I'll see you in 2017!
Great day today. Today was the final day, Sunday. I went to all 3 days and I had an amazing time. I was a part of history because it was the very first BroadwayCon. It was really, really amazing. I'm gonna make sure I put all the good clips that I got in this vlog, and I'm also gonna do a haul video for you guys and let you see what I bought from the marketplace. And I just had a really, really awesome time. Like, the experience was really great. I think that I'm going to go into further detail on my experience and haul video. So hopefully you guys will watch this video and watch all my other videos. And I appreciate you guys for watching and subscribing and liking and commenting. And I will talk to you later.